The Bentley Continental GT is a typically British sporting GT. It's fast, refined, and incredibly luxurious. It is not your typical race car. Yet that's exactly what Bentley has turned it into, a GT3 machine for the Blancpain Endurance Championship, British GT, and numerous other series. Today, we're getting to drive it at the Silverstone GP circuit with Bentley Boy and Works driver Stephen Kane, who's going to tell us a little bit more about the car and, bravely, give us some tuition. So can you tell us a little bit about the spec of the car?
Yeah, obviously the Continental GT3, it's our first step into the motorsport arena since back in the early 2000s. And with the Continental, it's Bentley has really tried to bring all that elegance and all the passion back into motorsport. And, you know, this is what we've got. We've got a V8 in the front here, which is it's a twin turbo. We've got a flat floor for underneath with a large splitter and a large rear wing.
How much does it weigh?
At the minute it's about 1280, but we run it at 1300 to 1315.
About a ton lighter, basically.
Yes, it is. Yeah. Yeah, it is. All the luxury items that Bentley has prided itself on has been taken out of it, and you're left with the bare raw shell, and Bentley goes to work on making it into a real racing car, and this is what you're left with. A lot of carbon fiber panels, carbon fiber splitter, and then you've got laser lights in the front for our endurance races, so right. Our long 24-hour races. All cooling package in the front, which is all carbon fiber, to get the maximum airflow into the intercoolers and radiators. Yeah. And then obviously big brakes, front and rear, and you know, a carbon fiber seat. And the dashboard is very, very similar to the original Continental, but it's made out of lightweight material. You know, this is a little bit what the driver has to deal with and what Bentley have. It's the steering wheel here, and it's in its form. It's not very round, but you know, we only need two places to grab onto, and with circuit racing you don't like to be doing too much oversteer, so the Continental's it handles pretty well, and we've got all the buttons. We've got pages for the dash, and then we've got map, and we've got TC, engine maps and ABS. So in for the engine map, you've got wet conditions or fuel saving. You know, because Bentley is really, its history is built in endurance racing after winning Le Mans in the early 20s. And, you know, it's all about robustness, yeah, elegance, and getting to the finish and winning. So, you know, our car is really strong, actually. It's the amount of testing that we've done and the endurability work. For me, it's the best car in the grid. A lot of this stuff is based around endurance racing for the long races to make sure that we get to the finish, we have good fuel comms, and we can make good strategy.
So you're going to let me sit in this car,
yeah,
and drive it,
yeah,
and you're going to sit in the passenger seat.
Yeah.
You're a brave man.
Yeah. I hope I made the right decision.
With Stephen Kane sitting alongside, it was time to get to grips with both the Bentley Continental GT3 and the Silverstone GP circuit. We'd learnt the lines the day before in a simulator, but now it was time to put it into practice with real-world speed and the consequences that go with it. And as you can probably guess, simulators don't have a tricky race clutch either. Out on track, the fearsome performance, the high-speed grip, and the massive potential of Bentley were all quickly apparent. I was going to need to raise my game. But having Stephen alongside, encouraging me to keep the throttle flat through faster stuff and to be patient through the tighter turns, really fast-tracked the learning curve, and I started to gain confidence. After a few laps, he trusted me enough to go out on my own.
That was mega. Well done.
Oh,
that was
brilliant.
Really good.
Thank you for
sitting. So we're going out on the Silverstone GP circuit in the Bentley Continental GT3. Oh my god!
With Stephen's feedback ringing in my ears, I went back out feeling more confident to push harder. And when you do that, the Bentley suddenly steps up a notch. Power floods in instantly with no lag from the twin turbochargers. The gear ratios are tight, the shifts are super fast, and you've got around 600 brake horsepower propelling 1300 kilos. So the sensation is of a constant cycle of speed slamming you back in the seat. In the really fast corners, the grip and stability is mind-blowing. Where in most cars you'd already be well beyond the limit, in the Bentley I had to take the leap of faith to push harder and go faster. The high-speed characteristics are quite a contrast to the low-speed corners, where the Bentley has much more power than grip because the all-wheel drive system has been removed, leaving it rear-wheel drive only. It's all about carrying the speed into those corners, wiping it off with a strong, easy-to-modulate brakes, and then rolling the car through the apex off power, leaning on the grippy front end. It's a lot to take in, but it helps that the Bentley never once felt unpredictable, which allows you to quickly build confidence, even with just a handful of laps.
So we've just been out in the Bentley and it's an absolutely amazing car. The power, the brakes, the handling, it's just another level. Learning to come off the brakes and roll the car into the corner at speed, knowing the front end will grip, is taking me quite a while to get used to that because I'm used to thinking it will understeer through some of the faster stuff. Keeping it flat, I know to keep it flat, and when you don't, it starts to move a little bit more, and the last thing you feel like you should do is add throttle, and that's exactly what you need to do, and it's just the level of commitment required is just a complete leap of faith. So I'm getting there, but I'm still a long way off with this car. It's a real beast. It's friendly enough to learn to drive to a certain level, but I think to get to the top level, people like Stephen Kane, I've got a newfound respect for them. What they do is amazing.